Here's a picture of a micrometeoroid impact on one of the windows of the International Space Station. Here's another image. On the right, you can see the damage on one of Webb's 18 hexagonal golden mirrors called C3. Webb telescope has been hit. Its primary mirror was damaged by 6 micrometeoroids, one of which left a significant mark. Scientists expect these tiny rocks to hit here and there, but this one turned out to be worse than first thought. Meteoroids are usually less than a millimeter in size, but as tiny as they can fly as fast as 10 kilometers per second or 22,000 miles per hour and cause significant damage to spacecraft or even astronauts during EVAs. Here's a picture of a micrometeoroid impact on one of the windows of the International Space Station. Here's another image. On the right, you can see the damage on one of Webb's 18 hexagonal golden mirrors called C3 after being struck by an unexpectedly large micrometeoroid. The impact, which likely happened between May 23rd and May 25th of this year, left permanent damage. The good news is that this is not a big deal and won't interrupt Webb's scientific goals. But the bad news has to do with the long-term effects of these micrometeoroids. Webb has enough fuel to do remarkable science for at least 20 years, but now scientists aren't sure how much micrometeoroid strikes will affect its operations. The engineers who designed Webb are aware that the mirrors and sun shield will eventually degrade from micrometeoroid impacts. Scientists also know that charged particles will gradually damage Webb's detectors, while its sun shield and 5-layer insulation will degrade from space weathering. Since its launch on December 25, 2021, NASA's Space Observatory has been struck by at least 19 tiny space rocks. The U.S. Space Surveillance Network keeps track of more than 23,000 pieces of orbital debris, each larger than a softball. However, millions of other pieces smaller than that are almost impossible to monitor. Scientists are now focused on investigating whether the C3 collision was a rare event that happens once in several years, or whether the telescope may be more susceptible to damage by micrometeoroids than pre-launch modeling predicted. Although experts believe this is a once-in-several-years event, one solution could be minimizing the amount of time Webb points directly into its orbital direction, which according to NASA statistically has higher micrometeoroid rates and energies. According to the journal Nature, engineers are keeping an eye on potential future dust-generating events, such as in 2023 and 2024, when scientists expect Webb to fly through particles left behind by Halley's Comet. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.